Hi, Eric Yates here from motorcycletrailers4hire.co.uk. Today we've got the big Phoenix trailer and we're going to go through the process of loading a bike. This is a really simple process, how to tie it down and how to make it safe for you and use on the road. This particular trailer, we've got a huge wide ramp here, very easy to access, not just a bike but a quad. And if you want to just hear, all we do is we undo these brackets. One here. And just slide that down flat. And there we have it, EV access. Now, in order to get the bike on safely, we've got these both ramps that we drop down. One. So once you're in the trailer, once the wheel is in the front clamp, still worthwhile. Well, this trailer will be a nice wide bed, put your stand down and get off the vehicle. So the bike's on the trailer, it's in gear and the side stand down. All we need now is strap it down. All it requires really is just four solid straps, which we'll go through now. Each of our trailers come with a range of equipment, including all the straps you require, both a lock to use on the trailer when it's static, and if you store on the trailer overnight, we've also got a wheel lock. Okay, let's go through the process of strapping the bike down. Okay, we're going to strap this bike down now. This bike here with the BNGS has lots of places to strap down. The idea being, it can go around the forks on some of the sports bikes, which means the suspension can be independent, or you can strap it down against the suspension, which we're going to do in this case. But the important thing is that it's pulled far enough forward to sit firmly in the D. Strap. First thing is to put your clamp on here, also get the strap on the same one, feed the strap again through the bike where it's not going to move, but feed the strap through here nice and taut, and then back down into your clamp. Once you've got it in the clamp, all you're going to do is just to have it on the in the clamp a couple of turns just to take up the slack. You want it nice and slack on this side, because we're going to go around and do the exact the same on the other side. Same thing, strap on here, strap into here, work it round the bike, and then back through. A little bit fiddly this bit, but once it's in, pull it fairly taut, and then get few turns. Now from this side, what we want to do on this side is we want to bring the bike up, adjusting it as we go. So we're bringing the bike up, and you can't do this independently. We'll bring the brake so it starts to stand. And you can see from there, the bike is fairly secure, it's nice and upright, and that's all taut, and the other one's taut on the other side. Okay, both straps are secure, now it's time for the back. We're looking at a suitable anchor point, frames are fairly good, so you put on your strap, and put it on the anchor point. Now before you do, a little bit of note of caution on this trailer, this bar, which holds the ramp, will need to be relocated, otherwise if you apply your strap, you can't then put the bar back. So make sure that's to the back of the trailer, find your location spot, round we go, and then again clamp on. Great little tip with the clamps is to place it through the clamp like so, and then come back through the hole so you can keep it nice and taut when you do the first few turns. And again, a few turns on that. That straps on secure. Inside the bike, again, be mindful that this needs to be go at the back of the trailer, otherwise you'll trap it in the trap. Find a suitable anchor point. Let's go around the frame here. Keep the straps nice and tidy. And then look to locate your clamp. Similar thing, tip is to get the clamp through the clamp, back through itself, helps with an easy way of keeping it nice and taut. Get to the level that you want it to. And simply clamp away. Once you've got the bike standing up nice and straight and clamped into place, it's time to go round and tidy. Now the way to do here is to make a nice loop, wrap around itself and back through. Yeah, and we can do that. This one here, so and releasing is easy and simple. You simply pull that to release. So one more time, you make a loop, wrap around through, pull it down. Keeps it nice and tidy for on the road. Just follow me around the other side. Again, just a little tensions on here, nice and solid. Little loop, round, tension. This one can do with two, little loop, tension. Okay, so that's all four straps on. That's the bike up square, nice and solid. You can see that it's actually going nowhere. Now it's a simple case of attaching the ramp. Okay, ramp, safety first. Up the ramp comes. You've got your locking pin. The ramp on this side goes with the main body of the ramp. Screw in the pin. And this one secures the back top ramp, same thing, through here into the hole and wind up. The bike's all on. All we're going to do now simply is to place it on the tow bar. Obviously we're doing this on a flat surface. Be mindful if this was a steep lane, you might want to leave the trailer on the tow bar. Detach the breakaway cable. Depending on your vehicle, you're looking to wrap it around somewhere, so in case of it become attached. On this particular trailer, it's just enough to wrap around the tow bar, back around itself, and then clip it back in to the trim. Legally important for making sure the trailer doesn't break away from your vehicle. Then simply attach the electrics. Right, raise the jockey right the way up to the top, clamp it firmly. And there is a tendency, if this is slack, they can unwind. So make sure you wind it right to the top, put a little bit of a couple of turns on, so this is nice and secure, and therefore can't work itself loose and work way down and make contact with the road. Just to show how secure this is, four straps enough. Feel free to put more on. But once the vehicle's up, once the vehicle spikes on, it's going nowhere.